If you've ever poked around in the settings of your favorite apps, you might have seen something called webhooks. They can be a tricky concept, so let's break it down. Webhooks are just another way that apps can send messages or information to other apps automatically. For example, how your e-commerce store notifies you in Slack about your new orders. In the last section, we talked about how apps talk to each other through polling. Polling is like knocking on your friend's door and asking if they have any sugar. In this case, information is the sugar. But you have to ask for it every time you want it, at a regular frequency. Webhooks are like if someone tossed a bag of sugar at your house anytime they buy some at the store. You don't have to ask, and you don't have to visit every 15 minutes. That's why webhooks are faster than polling. In fact, they happen almost instantly. They're more efficient, too. Webhooks usually fire when a specific event happens in an app, like new orders in your store or new contacts in your CRM. When something happens in your trigger app, say new orders, a webhook will send a message to your action app. That message follows a specific structure called Hypertext Transfer Protocol, or HTTP. That sounds familiar, right? You've probably seen it when you've typed in a web address in your browser. When you navigate to a URL on your browser, the browser is sending HTTP requests to that URL. That's how your browser can display a website on your screen. Think of HTTP as kind of a social etiquette for computers. There's rules for how they speak to each other. It's important to know those rules so when you're dealing with webhooks, you understand what's happening. An HTTP request will include four things. 1. A URL. You're most familiar with this by using your web browser. The URL indicates where you want to send the HTTP request. 2. A body. The body will have the information you want to send to another app. 3. A header. The header will specify, among other things, how the information in the body is formatted. For webhooks, it'll usually be formatted in XML, JSON, or form encoded in the URL. 4. A request method. Whenever a webhook sends an HTTP request, it needs to be specific about what it's asking the action app to do. Now, there's four methods you'll often come across in webhooks. A GET request will ask an app to retrieve existing information. A POST request will ask an app to create new information. A PUT request will ask an app to edit or update information. A DELETE request will ask an app to delete something. Request methods are pretty easy to remember since they tend to do what they say they'll do. All those elements are included whenever a webhook sends an HTTP request to your action app. And once your app receives the request, it'll then send a callback message, also known as a response, letting your trigger app know if the action app was able to complete the request successfully. That's webhooks in a nutshell. And you can send them in Zaps using Zapier's webhooks tool. Let's say you use an app that's not supported by Zapier, but you notice in your account settings that it has webhook functionality. You can use our webhooks tool to incorporate that app into your automated workflows. Zapier can use webhooks as a trigger or an action. You can pass information from a webhook to another app, or you can send app information to a webhook. We just threw a lot at you, so let's review. Webhooks are another way apps can send messages or information to other apps automatically. They're faster and more efficient than polling because it'll automatically send the information you need whenever it's available. When something happens in your trigger app, like a new contact, a webhook will send a message to your action app. That message is called a request. That request follows a specific structure called Hypertext Transfer Protocol, or HTTP. HTTP requests from a webhook include four things: a URL specifying where you want to send the data, a body, which has the information you want to send to another app, a header, which will specify how the information in the body is formatted, and a request method, which will specify what it wants the action app to do. The most common ones are GET, POST, PUT, and DELETE. Once an app receives the HTTP request from a webhook, it'll send a response, letting your trigger app know if the request was completed successfully. We'll see you in the next lesson. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to hit the like button below. And if you're new to this channel and enjoy this sort of content, consider hitting the subscribe button too. Thanks.